Hello all, my name is Zohir Choudhury, and we will begin with the definition of environmental health. We will learn what environmental health is by going over definitions from some well-known agencies in the United States and around the world. First of all, how does the World Health Organization or WHO define environmental health? According to WHO, environmental health comprises those aspects of human health, including quality of life, that are determined by physical, chemical, biological, social, and psychosocial factors in the environment. It also refers to the theory and practice of assessing, correcting, controlling, and preventing those factors in the environment that can potentially affect adversely the health of present and future generations. Please note in here the terms physical, chemical, biological, social, and psychosocial factors in the environment. These specific terms are recurring, and you will see them in various definitions that we'll go over today. Clean air, stable climate, adequate water, sanitation and hygiene, safe use of chemicals, protection from radiation, healthy and safe workplaces, sound agricultural practices, health supporting cities and built environments are all prerequisite for good health. Healthy environments could prevent almost one quarter of the global burden of disease, according to the WHO. COVID-19 pandemic is a further reminder of the delicate relationship between people and our planet. Another very important agency in the United States is ATSDR, which stands for Agency for Toxic Substances and Disease Registry. According to this agency, environmental health is the branch of public health that protects against the effects of environmental hazard that can adversely affect health or the ecological balances essential to human health and environmental quality. The National Environmental Health Association, which is a professional organization for environmental health professionals in the United States, also has a definition for environmental health. Environmental health is the science and practice of preventing human injury and illness and promoting well-being by identifying and evaluating environmental sources and hazardous agents and limiting exposures to hazardous physical, chemical, and biological agents in air, water, soil, food, and other environmental media or settings that may adversely affect human health. Here, we see those terms again, the physical, chemical, and biological agents, but also we see where these agents are present in the air, in the water, in the soil, in the food, or other environmental compartments or media, as it shows in here. Adding on to these definitions, the European Charter on Environment and Health states that environmental health includes both the direct pathological effects of chemical radiation and some biological agents and the effects, often indirect, on health and well-being of the broad physical, psychological, social, and aesthetic environment, which includes housing, urban development, land use and transport. Here you can again see those specific factors, chemical, radiation, biological, at the same time where these factors are affecting humans. So by going over all of these definitions, we can realize the major specific fields and subfields where environmental health professionals operate. The impact of mankind continuously threatens the quality of our air, water, land, and food supply. Within the discipline of environmental health, major fields are food safety, vector control, air, water quality, as well as climate change, hazardous and solid waste, radiation safety, and environmental justice and law, to name a few. Besides this, we also have other fields such as occupational and industrial hygiene, environmental toxicology, for example. So to briefly go over some of these fields so you are aware of what the main responsibilities are within these fields, let's go over them. So food safety deals with the enforcement of health and safety standards in the handling of food preparation for the public. It also educates food operators on proper food preparation and service. Vector control, on the other hand, deals with enforcement of various public health laws, sanitary codes, and other regulations related to spread of disease by vectors, such as mosquito-borne diseases, as well as other zoonotic diseases. Air and water quality and climate change focus on monitoring and enforcing government regulations for protecting the air, water, and preventing climate change. The potential threat to human health posed by contaminated air, water, and changing climate cannot be underestimated. It's so important. Hazardous and solid waste, on the other hand, focus on overseeing household waste collection and disposal, since improper disposal of household hazardous waste can pollute the environment and pose a threat to human health. Radiation safety focuses on safe usage of radiation and radioactive materials, as well as regulatory compliance. And finally, environmental justice and law focus on providing input to government agencies, assisting in the formulation of environmental policies, and may be involved in litigation concerning environmental health problems as well. So hopefully, by going over these definitions and the major fields of environmental health, you've been able to understand what environmental professionals work with and what they're trying to prevent. Hopefully, this was useful for you. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Thank you.